So let's review our rules.
Okay. So I'm trying not to...
Rules.
Oh, yeah.
So the rule one is to listen and not to interrupt people while they're speaking. Rule two is to slant. Rule three is to ask questions and not ask any questions. You have to at least ask two questions or one question during this whole book club meeting. Okay, so we have more rules, but I think those are like the main ones. So who wants to start with their goal?
Tina, you can go first.
So my goal is to be active, because usually I don't really talk that much.
That's my goal.
Brian, would you like to go second?
Mm-hmm. My goal is mostly to ask a few questions and add on to people and stay on track. Mostly I lose track and don't answer that often. I might be sort of nervous, so I might talk at my goal mostly.
Maybe like mine similar to Ryan, to make like the group stay on track longer, so then no one will stop. And yeah.
My goal is not to talk too much and try to not interrupt as much, and as the same as you guys, to keep it going. Who would like to share the rest of these first? It's from chapter 3 to the end.
Is it chapter 8 to the
end? Oh yeah, chapter 8 to the end.
Since I go, I got first, so can I go last now?
Okay, I can go first if no one wants to go first.
Okay.
So, if you go to page 8.
Page 8.
I mean chapter 8. Oh. Sorry.
It's okay.
Page 60.
It's gonna be kind of hard for me.
Is everybody there?
Yes.
So I think that Joshua will move up to fourth grade since Miss Goodwin is helping him a lot. And I feel strong about him moving up. Page
70.
I think Joshua will say to Tommy, you can't play with the fourth graders, when Tommy came into the third grade class and had to sit there for a while, because he did the same thing to Joshua. I think Joshua's going to get him back. Page 65.
Pass the test.
Page 73. I had a new word. Flinch. She looked in the cage of the mother flinch and the two baby flinch.
Finch?
She looked in the cage of the mother flinch at the two baby flinches. I think it's like some type of animal.
Yeah.
Cause why would something be in a cage?
I think it's like the snake's name, cause she had like a bowl for the pet.
Oh.
I agree with you. It might be an animal because it says a mother flinch and two
a new word for me too, because I didn't notice that because I read on too quick. But then I think a flinch is like some sort of dog.
I agree with Tina. I think it's a snake, but I just have to add on, it's not really her snake, it's her husband's snake, so that's most probably why it's in the cage. Because for me, I predict that it's Halloween right now, and the husband said that he would move out on Halloween. So I predict that it might be the husband's snake. Chapter 10. I think that he will pass the test again, and Miss Goodwin will be so happy, and Andrew and him can be seen together again because of Tommy, he made the rule. Page 78. 78, yeah. I said, I think when Joshua leaves the third grade, he'll be actually sad because even though he was upset when he first came, I think that he made new friends and likes Miss Goodwin. And then page 80. The movie in my mind was so strong when he got a fudge sundae because I could imagine it and imagine how it tasted. That's all my statements.
Can I go next?
Yep.
Tommy does not know how to read because he was scared.
I agree with you. I think that he was scared because he actually kind of looked scared and he asked Joshua for help. Mm-hmm.
Page 70. I think when Tommy said I'm smart enough when I'm in class, I think Tommy told everyone that he is smarter, but he is not.
I agree with you because why would he be smarter in, I was thinking, when you read that, I was thinking, why would he be smarter in fourth grade than in third grade? So, it's a bit weird.
Yeah.
So I agree with you.
I think Tommy feels really angry for losing the games, so that he quit. New word. I took tests for fourth grade this morning and essayed.
Aced it. It means like I did really well in it. I was like, I'm gonna automatically pass because I did it so well. I understood it all. It was like so easy.
Page 79. When Mrs. Gilman said, "So you are Joshua," was so excited to go past him.
When Mrs. Gilman said that Joshua passed?
Yeah. I think Joshua was so excited that he passed third grade.
Okay.
On page, I have a lot of new words because didn't understand that much. Like on page 24. Back in the classroom, Joshua told Miss Goodwin that he had a flu and need to go home.
Where's the pronoun there?
Oh, that's right. Go home,
Pronto.
Pronto,
it means like right away.
Okay.
No matter what, right away.
And another new word on page 33.
Okay.
So it was on half a sentence because the sentence was so long, but it was here. Joshua bought a double dip chocolate ice cream cone at the counter and a copy of Mr. Strange and walked home along Wisconsin
Avenue. I think that's Like, I don't know how to explain Avenue.
Maybe Tinny.
Yeah, I think it's like Wisconsin Avenue is most probably a type of like a street name.
Okay. I agree with Halia. And on page 60. So on the one afternoon, Joshua first quarter was on the resting on the rest of the mail, but then when he came back home, he didn't see his report card, so I was shocked that Joshua didn't see his report card.
I disagree because it says that when he got home, he saw his report card, and then he hid it behind something. I forget what. And then he lied to Amanda. Lied to Amanda and said, I didn't see my report card when I got home, and she's like, but it was under mine, so he lied to Amanda.
Yeah, that's right.
Yes? I also agree with Halia because it says that you got your report card, Amanda called, so I agree.
Another new word? It's just, it's like, I don't know that much, but it's on page 66. A new word is console. It was on, yep, Joshua said shrugging his shoulders to console his great pressure. It's not bad.
I think it's kind of like to like hide his like really excitedness, just to be like kind of cool and be like, yeah, it's not bad. Instead of being, it's not bad, it's not bad, it's not bad.
And that's all.
I agree with Halia because like usually boys don't share their feelings too much. So, yeah.
I agree with Tina. Boys don't share their feelings.
Yeah. Okay, so, Tina.
Here to page 10.
Page 10.
That's all the way in chapter 1.
Joshua wanted to quit third grade, but now I think that he doesn't because he said he promised that he would not quit again.
I think that we already heard that. Yeah, I remember.
I think it's.
I think he didn't hear your sticky from chapter 3, maybe?
Yeah, chapter 3 to 8.
Yeah. No, 8 to chapter
89?
Yeah. 89?
20. 20? So my question is, why did the enemies hate Joshua that much?
I can tell you the answer. Because Joshua got mad at Tommy for Tommy laughing at him when he got struck out. So I think that since he was fighting with Tommy's friend, the enemies, what it says in this book, the enemies started getting mad and started helping Tommy and not attacking Joshua because Joshua attacked Tommy.
I agree with Halia, and when Tommy and Joshua talk to each other, and when Joshua hit Tommy, they started a really big fight. So I think they're
because I have a lot of questions that relate to the wives. This is another one.
Page too.
Just share these.
And you still think that they're there?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. I used to think Joshua's only changed, but not. But now I think they didn't because they stole Jesus.
I have a question. How did you think Joshua's enemy changed? Like, what like they told you that maybe he changed?
Cause like they got in, when they got in the fight, they got to the principal, so they didn't want to get in trouble. They didn't want to get in trouble again, so they just kind of be nice.
Where does it say it?
When they got in the fight.
But when they got in trouble, Miss Goodwin said that never ever fight again, and he told Joshua to say like a bunch of times not to fight again, so then they don't fight again. So I think they will stop.
I agree with Lisa. Is there a new word?
The movie was really,
1864.
Mm-hmm. So I think the movie was really strong in my mind when Mrs. Goodwin packed the books because it might be a packing to the new house. And the second one is that I predict that Joshua would change because he heard the story about Jonathan. And standardized, I think it was. Which one?
What sentence are you using?
Standardized is when they standardized test.
I think standardized is like the official test to see if he's going into fourth grade, like official test. And what's your other one?
Promoted.
Promoted is like I'm promoted into fifth grade, so that means like promoted maybe is like
just a tryout.
Yeah, it's kind of
just redo it.
Well, actually, like if you're like a student or something and like you got promoted into assistant, it's like you got promoted into a higher level, so you're moving up. So for example, if you're in like A, for example, like reading level A, you got promoted into B, so you got to a higher level.
Page 68, this is another question about enemies. So why does Tommy Wilhelm care about Joshua flunking for grade so much?
I think because he can make fun of him for it. So maybe.
Can you ask the question again?
Yeah, we did.
You might want to speak up a bit more.
Why does Tommy Wilhelm care about Joshua Flunky for a grade so much?
Because he can make fun of him for it.
Because now Tommy feels the same way as Joshua right now because he got promoted into third grade again, so he will feel the same way he would that Joshua would feel, but then he would be promoted soon into fourth grade again.
Is that all you need to add on? Should we share our reading responses?
I don't know.
I think we usually do, right?
Yeah, so I think Halia and me should share first.
And then I'll go first.
And I'll go second.
Is it first, second,
wait, this is mine, right?
Yeah.
Yes. So can we, like, even if we didn't finish, we
Just read what we have.
So
I said, today I read The Plunking of Joshua T. Bates. I really liked that book because the whole way through until the end, I thought that Joshua will make it to the fourth grade. And when he did, I was so happy for him because I could feel his excitement and how he felt. At first, I liked Tommy, but then when he was so mean to Joshua and Andrew, I wanted to like hurt him. And his friends, when the third graders beat the fourth graders, I was so happy for the third graders. And when how Tommy changed was when Joshua came back to school, the first day after summer, when he came back, Tommy used to like hide to him. But then at recess, they got into a fight. So that's, for me, how Tommy changed.
Today I read a book called Fourth Grade Teammates. When Joshua had to do this test to get to fourth grade, I was